Hello everyone, welcome back to Radiology Short Cases. Today we have a 33-year-old male with history of dizziness and headache. The patient was advised MRI of the brain with contrast. These are axial T2-weighted and axial flare images of the brain. We can see there is a well-defined hyperintense cystic lesion in the right cerebellum and vermis with a iso2 hyperintense mural nodule at the periphery and surrounding vasogenic edema. This edema is causing compression of the brainstem and fourth ventricle. Similar findings we can appreciate on the flare images. The mural nodule here is hyperintense and the edema is also extending into the left cerebellum. This is a sagittal T1 weighted image. Pre-contrast, the cystic lesion is again seen in the cerebellum, however, edema and mural nodule are not appreciable here. On DWI images, there is no restriction of the lesion as well as mural nodule. On post-contrast, coronal and axial T1 weighted images, the cystic lesion is non-enhancing and the peripheral mural nodule shows homogeneous enhancement with a serpentine flow void at the periphery. And again on the axial T1 post-contrast images, we can see the homogeneous enhancement of the mural nodule. Based on these findings, the diagnosis of right cerebellar hemangioblastoma was considered and was later confirmed on surgery. Few words about cerebellar hemangioblastomas. Hemangioblastomas are tumors of vascular origin which can occur both sporadically and in patients with von Hippel-Lindau syndrome. These are WHO grade 1 tumors in the central nervous system or can be seen elsewhere in the body like kidneys, liver and pancreas. They have typical imaging findings and in 60% of the cases they appear as sharply demarcated homogeneous cystic masses with non-enhancing walls except for mural nodule. And in 40% cases, they appear as solid tumors. On CT, mural nodule is isodense to the brain on non-contrast CT scan and the cystic cavity is of fluid density. And on post-contrast images, there is homogeneous enhancement of the nodule. However, there is no enhancement of the cyst wall and calcification is usually not a feature of this lesion. On MRI, on T1, the mural nodule is hypo to isointense and cystic cavity is of CSF signal intensity. On post-contrast T1 weighted images, there is enhancement of the mural nodule but no enhancement of the wall. On T2, mural nodule shows hyperintense signal and we can sometimes see flow voids due to the enlarged vessels at the periphery of the cyst as we saw in our case. And CSF intensity cystic cavity is seen. Now, what is the differential diagnosis of posterior fossa mass tumors in children? The most common tumor is pilocystic astrocytoma, followed by brainstem glioma, medulloblastoma, ependymoma, atypical rhabdoid or teratoid tumors. In children, if hemangioblastoma is seen, it's most commonly seen in von Hippel-Lindau cases. And mnemonic to remember this differential list is beam. In adults, the most common differential is metastasis and this metastasis is generally from the lungs or breast, and hemangioblastoma is the most common posterior fossa tumor but it's a primary tumor. And astrocytoma, medulloblastoma and ependymoma, they are also seen but they are encountered in younger adults and rarely in the older adults. Other differentials are lymphoma, Lerner-Duchler's disease and subependymoma, which is most frequently seen near the obex. Thank you very much for the patient listening.